दिस इज अ हर्ब कॉल्ड मलबार कैट मिंट एंड वेरी टाइनी एंड क्वाइट प्रिटी फ्लावर्स आर देयर. That's how the flower looks. That light kind of pinkish petals are there, and then behind there is one more dark gray, dark kind of violet structure. That is, I think, where the pollen and all comes. Yeah, that's how it looks. Very tiny flowers. Then leaves are looking like this, quite pretty, and it's quite soft, not too dry, not succulent also, juicy and succulent also. It's a perennial plant. It, in a good location, it can grow up to some 5-6 feet and all. Then it comes in this category of places called as neglected places. That is, places where they have done some clearing and then abandoned for many years, where native plants can come and reoccupy. This site is a roadside empty site of somebody's someone's housing site. I think by looking at the plants and all, I think it has been clear cut some 10 years back and all, and then they have left it as it is, and some of the plants have all have come and occupied. And then in this particular site, it is next to a main road actually, this catmint, its botanical name is Anisomeles indica. So, only a little bit I'll tell about it now. This it's not particularly showy or anything, but it is pretty nevertheless, the flowers and all. Then this Anisomeles indica is called cat mint in a common language. Then it's also called Malabar catmint. Then it's an aromatic plant. These leaves are having a very strong smell. Not exactly unpleasant, nor is it pleasant. It's something in between. Some odd kind of bitterish smell is there. Then it has woody stems. These stems, in a more mature plant, it becomes quite woody. Then it grows wild and cultivated for ornamental as well as essential oil from the leaves and all. Because it has aromatic, and then it has lot of herbal applications also. Then its range is from India, Burma, Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, Vietnam, China, up to Japan and Papua New Guinea. So it's widespread in from India to eastwards. And it likes sunny open places as well as shady places. This particular plant is under jackfruit trees. So it can tolerate good amount of shade and some light sunlight it needs, but in full sunlight also it survives if watering is done. Then it likes wet soils also. It occurs in teak plantations and all, And if enough water is there, it will flower throughout the year. Otherwise, in the monsoon, post-monsoon time, it will flower and then it will be dormant for the some time till the next monsoon. Then it is this herb is used as a flavoring for that sago balls, it seems, sago cake. So it has some uses in culinary also. And then the herbal properties, it's astringent and appetizer, reduces fever, and it's a tonic herb. And it's used in folk medicine and all for fever. Then when children get this this fever because of a tooth growing, when the teeth starts growing, sometimes because of pain they get that fever and all, for that also it's used, it seems. So it's quite safe even for kids. Then it's also a tonic herb, and then it's used for fever, cold, skin diseases, snake bites, kidney stones, etc. Numerous uses are there. Then apart from that, it is also mosquito repellent. So if you have a lot of mosquitoes in your garden, you can grow this. It's a good plant. And also that crushed leaves, if it is burnt with some used as a fumigant, so you can grow, you can mix with some eucalyptus and vitex and all such leaves and burn it, and it will help to get rid of the mosquitoes. So that's a bit about this Anisomeles indica. Then also it is a host to some butterflies. And today we are lucky to see those moths. They kind of make this kind of nest, those caterpillars, and then those caterpillars, they hide inside this kind of nesting constructions. Let me try to open one so that we can have a look at that. Those caterpillars also. They have stitched it up into some intricate they make these little nesting type of structure, and then they go inside there and they hide there in the daytime, and then in the night I think they come out and eat the leaves. So anyway, not able to find the anyway. So this is how it looks, and it's a plant worth having in the garden, because not only it's pretty, repels mosquitoes and herb and all.